I'll be the best alive. I'm gonna show you how to do it right. You'll see how you should be living life. But when you do, it's not that hard. Really gonna wanna give it everything.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and welcome to Wareham High School's Clem's Delane Field for tonight's South Coast Conference football game between the Bourne Canalmen and your Wareham Vikings. On behalf of the administration, staff, and students of Wareham High School, we welcome Bourne High School to this contest. This competition is conducted in accordance with the rules and regulations of the Massachusetts Interscholastic Athletic Association and the South Coast Conference. The game officials are responsible for administering the rules of the game. Their experience and integrity qualify them for this important responsibility. Athletes and fans are expected to demonstrate good sportsmanship to everyone here. Negative behavior will not be tolerated.
When should we stop talking?
From the stadium.
After
now,
national anthem,
at
maybe?
This time, okay. Please rise for the national anthem.
Gangle, alongside of me is Brad Cornish for tonight's football game. We're here at Spillane Field, Wareham High School, with this clash between the Bourne Canalmen, who are 0-1, and the Wareham Vikings, who are 1-0. Bourne lost to Upper Cape their first game, 27-6, and Wareham won their opener at Atlantis Charter School last week in Fall River, 36-0. So let's see who won the toss here. We'll kick off to Bourne.
It's exciting to be here for this opening game, Paul. There's nine seniors on the group of players for Wareham this year, so I think there's a lot of hope that they're going to be pretty representative as a team this year. So.
I can hear it. I have headsets
on.
So it looks like it's going to be Dominic Lobel, number 18 for Wareham, kicking off. Ball's on the 40-yard line. Back deep for Bourne Canalmen is Jamin Scott, senior. Let's see if Dominic Lobel kicks a squib or a...
Thank you.
Looks like the quarterback for Bourne is Sean McDonough. He's a junior, 5'9".
The past few days.
Besides a win, that'll be a 5-yard penalty.
First down. Oh, we're back to 1st and 10 again.
That's right.
Parker Fram and Dominic LaBelle up front here.
Carrying the ball. Jamon Scott.
And a long 7 yards to go for the first down for the Bourne Canalmen. Look pretty close to me.
Where's the instant replay when you need it?
So, 1st and 10 on the 41 and a half yard line of Bourne. Bourne with a full house backfield here.
Vikings football.
It looked like Brandon Fleming came up with that recovery ball.
Number 51, Brandon Famous, senior defensive lineman. And they'll take over at the 41 of Bourne. 1st and 10. Kyle Delgado is the centerman.
So we got...
I got Alvin Lopes at quarterback right now.
Alvin Lopes.
Team will wear him. Just inside the 50-yard line. Again, Avon Lopes calling signals here for Wareham.
We got rid of that just in time.
Third down.
Or it would have been sacked, Paul. That pass was to...
Play action to the right. Looking for Del Brito.
And Brito, yes. Landon Brito.
Intercepted, but
it bounced got off.
Desi Powell, that'll be a reception, but it'll be about 2 yards short of the first down. Be fourth and two.
I think they're going to go for it here, Paul.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Why not? That was a fortunate bounce right into Dizzy's hands. But he showed good hands.
A legal formation on their end. That'll be a 5-yard penalty. Repeat third and down.
What? Ooh.
Wow. It's third and 20.
That nullified that play, Paul.
It sure did.
That's unfortunate.
Back to the 49-yard line. Wideouts here. Gilly Jallo and Henry Jones. Long pass.
He's wide open.
Gilly, oh, he dropped it. Wow.
Oh.
Incomplete pass brings up fourth down.
Was that, Paul?
That's Gilly Jallo.
Gilly Jallo dropped a wide open pass. He would have been in the end zone if he caught that. That's okay. Looks like Gilly's back to punt, Paul. Unless it's a fake, but I would doubt it. Oof,
short punt here, coming over to the left of us here. At about the 37-yard line.
Be down at the 30.
I was down by
Board Football.
Desi Powell, so.
We've got a timeout for Bourne. They're first.
Time is in here, too.
So far, there's been quite a few mistakes in this game, Paul. Yeah. The kids, I think, are a little nervous.
The opening two plays were offsides on both teams.
Yep.
Early game here, too, Brad. I think it's because of the Triple E
threat. Yep, yeah. That's right, yeah. They got in the line right now. They got right in the middle there is Raheem Jackson. He looks pretty small in there, but he's quick as anyone's going to be. Uh-oh.
That was Josh Gonzalez for
21, Joshua Gonzalez for 2 yards. That'll bring up second down for Bourne.
Second and eight for Bourne. At the 39-yard line. One with a full house backfield again. Oh, they got caught. He got caught behind the line of scrimmage.
A game tackle sack for the Wilhelm Vikings.
That's
bring up third
and
long.
Good 5-yard loss there, Paul.
Nice play.
Slow to get up off the turf is Dominic Lobel, number 18. A little burn on his elbow.
Oh.
That's not good.
No, it's not good. He's not moving that arm.
Yeah. From him with a first down.
Completed catch by number 5. The Raven Hawks gets Bourne a first down.
3 minutes and 41 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Boyne's got the ball on the 45-yard line.
But we're on the plan with the Vikings football.
That was number 60, Wayne Parker. Johnny on the spot there. Ball's at the 48-yard line of Wareham, who they'll take over. Second turnover by Vaughn here today. And we're still 3 minutes and 6 seconds here in the first quarter. No score. Henry Jones coming out to the left here. Wide out to wide outs to the right. Desi Powell, and I'm not sure who the other guy is. Gain of about 2 yards.
Landon Brito carried that one, Paul.
Senior running back. So long, eight yards to go for the first down here. The ball's right at the 50-yard line. Dominic Lavelle's back in the game.
That's good to see.
Got Powell and
Jones on one
Jones
side.
On the left side. There's Landon Brito again.
He gets
one of the play by the of Landon Brito. He will make 40 yards.
Third and 7 yards to go for the first down here.
Looks like a passing down, but.
Here's Gilly Jallo. And we got another flag thrown.
Run by Gilly Jallo. There's a flag on the play.
Could have been movement on Wareham.
It's a penalty on Wareham. It looks like
in the back, 10 yards.
On the on that run.
The Vikings will bring them to a third and long. Timeout, Vikings.
Very sloppy game here, Brad, here in the first quarter.
So far, yeah. Well, it's early in the season, so you got to expect errors. Wareham, a good percent of their kids are playing both ways here, too, so let's see if that makes a difference near the end of the game.
There's the fourth penalty called here today. First quarter. Not much offense here for Wareham.
Now,
in their first series, they had a big first down there, but Gilly Jallo couldn't hold on to the football at about the 28-yard line.
And he was wide open.
Wide open, and nothing but pay dirt.
He would have been in the end zone if he caught that ball.
So Wareham now fourth and a long 20 yards to go for the first down.
Ooh.
Wow, big loss.
Number 14
for the Canalmen.
That looks like Logan Cook came in and sacked Wareham's quarterback on that one. So Gillies back to punt call. Oh, that's a nice punt.
Taking at the 38-yard line by Vaughn.
Take him back.
14. Got a nice little game there.
Return of the play by Logan Cook to about the 56-yard line.
Logan Cook.
The 45-yard line.
That was about a 15-yard return, wouldn't you say, Paul?
Yeah, I would say that. Ball's marked on the 46-yard line of Wareham.
Neither team has got close to the 20-yard line of the opponent so far. This game's been played pretty much between the 30s.
Time out, Vikings.
That's the second time out this half, Paul.
Yep.
I don't know.
Probably with so many kids playing both ways, Brad, it's probably a very strategic timeout for where.
I think you're
Coach
right.
Fan
yep.
Cast.
Yep. I look like the numbers for Wareham to start this game were 26 kids, Paul. So that's more than last year in any game that I can remember. So. And I believe they have a freshman team this year too, so.
So we're heading back into their 4-3. Handoff, 1, 2, 3 yards, possibly 4 on that first carry by Bourne. Number 32, Ryan O'Connor.
Running about 5 on the 4 on the play. That'll bring up second down for the Canalmen.
Fumble. I think it was recovered by the
fumble on the
quarterback.
Recovered by Bourne. That'll bring up third down.
Sean McDonough, the quarterback, recovered his own fumble. That was on the exchange.
They've had a lot of problems with the exchange between the center and also between the running backs and the quarterback. So far.
Yeah, they're going with a full house backfield. There's not much space between the guys back there, number one. Oh, I think we got an offside.
I think that was a legal procedure, yes.
Yep.
Legal procedure on Bourne. It looked like the right end
ball
jumped
the
way before.
5-yard penalty.
What do we got, 2 minutes and
repeat,
12? 12, 13 seconds, Paul?
Yeah, it looks that way. About 9.5 yards for a first down. Third and 9.5 here on the Wareham 47.
Yeah, it almost looks like, actually it's 11 yards, Paul, because he's got the yard marker behind the
Oh. And Keem Jackson with the tackle there.
Sack for the Vikings brings up fourth down.
Look.
Good stop by Wareham there. Like Rakeem Jackson is the smallest guy out there.
I would say so. Yeah. he looks like about 125 pounds, Paul, but he plays right on the middle on defense, so he's a tough kid.
Yeah. A good punt. Going to go down to about the 12-yard line.
Yeah, nice, right out of bounds.
Yeah, ball out of bounds at the 12-yard line. Vikings ball.
No chance for Gilly Jallo to return that ball.
Let's see if Wareham can get their offense on track here, Paul. Move the ball.
Well, they got a long way to go here.
Yep.
88 yards to pay dirt.
Bourne doesn't seem to want to pass the ball very much.
No.
So if Wareham's pretty much stacking up the middle and making it difficult for him to run, too.
They'd announce my granddaughter's birthday at halftime.
We don't. You gotta go out to the
down there?
Yeah.
Thank you.
There's Gilly Jallo on a big carry. He's got the first down and some more.
Looks to me like Gilly got about 12 yards on that one, Paul. Maybe more.
It takes them out of the red zone.
That's right. He's out about to the 24, so that was good for 12. That's what he looked like last week. He was running right through Atlanta's charter. So
Gilly Jallo had 4 touchdowns last week, Brad, at Atlanta's charter.
Well over 100 yards.
Uh-oh. On the exchange, he picks it up.
Too bad.
Gets tackled. Loss of 2.
Loss of 2 on the play by Gilly Jallo. We'll bring up a
He just took his eye off the ball just after the exchange. He would have had, I think, some yardage on that one, too.
Bourne 0 and your Vikings 0.
So that's the end of the first quarter here, Brad. No score. Ball's on the 20-yard line.
This has got to make Wareham feel pretty good because last year they lost to Bourne twice.
Yeah,
and the scores were not close.
No, first one was 48-20, and the next one was 39-0.
That was Thanksgiving Day, yeah. So both of those games were probably pretty much over by halftime, so here they are, hanging right in there with Bourne this year.
Second and a long 16 to go. 14. Oh, an unbalanced line here.
That's completely unbalanced, Paul.
Timeout, Bourne, I think.
Yep, Bourne calls timeout.
They want to talk this over.
They don't know how to deal with this.
Timeout for the Canal Boys.
I don't know if that's what the coach wanted. He probably did want him to have to call another timeout. So
both teams have called 2 timeouts. That was Bourne's second timeout, I believe. A We haven't even got a tick off the clock here in the second quarter.
The start of each of these quarters has started kind of strange here, Paul. We have the two penalties at the start of the first quarter, and now the board has to call a timeout. So.
Ball on the 20-yard line.
They're going to run the same play, Paul, looks like.
First down, Bourne.
Fumble on the play will be a Bourne football.
At the 15-yard line.
15-yard line.
Turnover to the game. Second one by Wareham. It's a costly one. It balls on the 16-yard line. First and 10 for the Canal men. Full house backfield. Big yardage there.
The run of the play by number 32, Ryan O'Connor. Will bring up second and a three.
Big 7-yard gain there by one, number 32, Connor. Ryan O'Connor. Senior running back for Bourne. Connor gets two.
He's got the first down, Paul.
Looks like you might be right. First
we had
goal.
A fumble on the play, which results in a Viking football.
Is that the third, recovery, Paul, this game?
Third fumble recovery for wearing him.
I think Wareham should scrap that unbalanced line for the rest of the game. Let's just run some power football here and see if we can go through these guys.
So on the 6-yard line, Wareham will start. They got a long way to go, 94 yards.
We have a loss on the play for the Vikings.
Do you want me to take the other people who are doing that so we can be faster?
I'm doing that. All right. Just try to see if you can get the eye track.
Okay. What happened with you and I?
Girls, you're going to have to sit down.
Intercepted by the Bourne Canal men will bring up first down.
Logan Hawks, number 5, intercepted that ball.
Is that the second or third turnover by Wareham in this game?
I think that's the third turnover, Brad.
And Bourne's had, I believe, three too. So.
Six turnovers already, when not even into the second quarter yet.
It looks like about 10 minutes. The field position is favoring Bourne, though.
Ball on the 11-yard line. Offsides again. Nope, they didn't call it. Looked like offsides to me.
Run the play by number 32, Ryan O'Connor, is for a 1-yard loss.
And another loss for Bowen running the ball. So.
Number 32, Sean O'Connor, the junior.
Paul, Wareham's defense has been very good so far. The offense is putting them in bad positions right now, but they've been holding up this whole game so far.
Second and 11. On the 11. Number 14's got a big game here. Down to the 5-yard line.
Run on the play by number 14, Logan Cook, will bring up a third down.
Third and 5. Two down territory here, Brad. And they still can pick up a first down. Number 21, Joshua Gonzalez.
He's still short of the first down.
Sure, I think the play will bring up a fourth down for the Canalmen.
You got to believe they're going for it here.
Oh.
Unless they got a heck of a kicker, but the quarterback got another play. He's coming back on the field, so.
Looks like he got about 2 yards for the first down.
Yeah.
Think he's got it. Maybe not.
I don't know. I don't think he did, Paul. I'm not sure. Maybe.
Wow, it looks like Wareham stopped him.
I think they did.
Yes, they did.
They did.
Turtle down, Vikings ball.
Take over on the 3-yard line.
Wow.
Long way to go here.
You gotta be very careful with the ball here.
Nice little gain there.
Run on the play by number 21, Landon Britto.
Landon Britto with that.
Second down.
Got about 6.5, we'll say. Second and about 4 yards. Second and 4. Lopes calling the plays. Pitch out to Jallo. Gilly Jallo thrown back at the 10-yard line. Gain of 1. Uh-oh. We got a Viking down on the field.
Yeah. It looks like one of the linemen, Paul.
Yes. Yes.
So timeout on the field here for that injury. We haven't got, you got the number there, Brad?
I don't, Paul.
Who's saying that? Abby? No, I know about it. Don't worry about it.
Number 53, Brad.
Okay, that's...
Kai Delgado, the senior offensive
lineman. Everyone else is
lineman.
He was limping around earlier in the game, too, I noticed, but... And it was his knee that seemed to be bothering him earlier in the game, so... He's the center, Paul, so it's going to be important who plays center now. It's that exchange between the quarterback and the center is really important.
Well, the good news is that he's walking on it.
I don't need the laptop anymore tonight, so you can bring the laptop over to the next.
They're sending in a freshman, Paul. Number 64, Dylan Turner, to replace him. Now, whether he's going to play center, I'm not sure, but... Yeah, he is going to play center. So we've got a freshman playing center now, Paul.
Incomplete to Dizzy Powell.
Incomplete pass will bring up fourth down for the Vikings.
About 6 minutes and 33 seconds here left in the second quarter.
Wareham's got an eighth grader in on this play, Paul. Aiden Caron. That's
punt.
A nice punt.
Wow.
That's a beauty. What a great punt that was. That's a 52-yard ball. Wow. That was incredible. And the ball went out of bounds.
So there was no return
on it. Was that Gilly, Paul?
Yeah, that was Gilly. And not only that, he was probably 4 or 5 yards deep into the end zone. That's probably a 57-yarder.
I think you're right. That was incredible.
So they got themselves out of a little hole here.
Yeah. That completely changed the field position. They just need a little good luck, Paul.
So the iPad keeps dying, but you guys are still recording to that camera, so we're good.
Okay, all right.
And it's actually still recording to there, at least audio-wise, so we're still good.
Okay.
We just might have just a picture of the game.
First and 10, born on the 42-yard line. Big run. 9-yard gain.
Running a play by the Canalman will be for a fight. 9 yards. It'll be second down.
Ball on the 48-yard line of Wareham. Sean McDonough calling signals for Bourne here, number 11. Oh, nice tackle by Henry Jones.
14, Logan Cook.
Loss of one.
That was a beautiful tackle. If he gets by Henry,
third down.
He's going a long ways.
Third and two.
Wareham still got that their that freshman in there on defense too, Paul.
Yeah, number going both ways.
Yep, number 64, Dylan Turner.
I want to see how.
What do you think? Is it a first down, Paul?
No, it can't be.
He's a little sh- I don't
know. No. I thought so. I think that was the Bourne coach who called for that measurement.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So it's going to be third and about a, less than one, I guess. So.
We'll call it third and one. I think we're in two down territory here too, so if one doesn't get it.
Third down for the Canal Mill.
5 minutes and some odd seconds here. 5 minutes 32 to go. Got it and more down to the 40-yard line.
One of the play number 32, Ryan O'Connor, will be a first down for the Canal Men.
That's the third first down here in the first half by the Bourne Canal Men.
They're opening up some holes in the middle where Delgado usually plays, Paul. So.
Right.
They're still working on him over on the sideline, so.
At the 32 and in and out of
incomplete
his hands.
Incomplete pass on the play will bring up third down for the second down for the Canalmen.
Second and 10.
Logan Cook was the receiver who dropped that ball, so everybody seems to have problems catching passes today for both teams. So.
Might be only one's third attempt on, in the air, I think, today.
I think you're right. They're just trying to power the football here, so.
Second down, 10 yards to go on the 40-yard line. And he's got the first down.
Run of the play by number four, Jamin Scott, will bring up a first down for the Canalmen.
3:53 remaining here in the second quarter, first half. Ball on the 28-yard line of Wareham.
Run of the play by number four, Jamin Scott, for around 3 yards. That'll bring up second down for the Canalmen.
Second and a long six, maybe seven.
It's like about 3.5 minutes left, Paul, is it, or two?
Yeah, it's about three minutes and 50 some odd seconds to go. Or two, you might be right. Yep, it's 2 minutes and 46. Number, well,
I think we're going to have a hold in there. Yeah. But...
or a block in the back.
Oh, another Wareham player is down, Paul. It's, it looks like it's a Brent. Did he get up?
Yeah, he got up.
All right.
Personal foul, chop block.
He's holding his arm, too. So.
We'll move the ball back. It'll be second down for the Canalmen.
He may just have a stinger in his elbow, so...
Go for the first.
Was that holding, Paul? Or?
I think it was a chop block.
That's a 15-yarder?
15-yard penalty.
That's a big one.
That's a big one. Come on, another fumble. Wareham's got it.
Vikings football.
Johnny on the spot.
Dominic.
That. 2 minutes and 34 seconds here for Wareham to get something.
Don LaBelle caused that fumble. The quarterback saw him and he dropped the ball. So, coming. So. That was a nice play by both of the kids from Wareham. Bowie and...
46-yard line of Bourne.
And Julie.
What happened?
That looks like, what, about 205, Paul, or 209?
Yeah, 204, I think. Or 209. Big hole for Gilly again. Got about 5 yards on that, 5 or 6 yards.
Run about 5 yards for Gilly Jalla. We'll bring up second down Vikings.
A little surprised they're not, they got the... They're not hurrying up a little bit here, Paul.
No.
To get it in the end zone, they're going to have a big run or a...
Jones and Powell here, wide to the right. Another fumble.
It's got to be procedure. Or is there a timeout?
Neutral zone interaction on the Vikings will bring up second and 10.
Dominic LaBelle was offsides. By a host of tacklers from Bourne.
Loss of the play of one will bring up third down for the Vikings.
Third and 11. Two down territory here for the Wareham Vikings. Timeout.
Timeout Vikings.
That's their fourth, isn't it? The final timeout here?
Could be, yeah. What's there, about 44 seconds over there, Paul?
Yeah, 44. No score here. First half. Four seconds left in the first half. Ball and the 48-yard line of Bourne. yard and 12 yards to go.
No one in the backfield. No.
Now no.
Gilly comes back.
I already put it on.
Got a couple. Not much.
Run by Gilly Zello for 3 yards. Brings up fourth down to the Vikings.
21 seconds to go. This might be the last play.
They may let the clock run out here.
No, they're going to run one play.
15 seconds left in the half.
This should be the last play. Long pass.
And the half-time
the result of the play is an incomplete pass. That brings our halftime to an end. The score, Born Carnarvon 0, your Wareham Vikings 0.
So?
Please be sure to visit
no
our
score,
Snapchat.
No score, 0-0 here
located
at the conclusion of this first half, Brad.
South corner and, of the end zone.
Kind of sloppy play.
Wareham is the whole second quarter. The play was in Wareham's end of the field, so they never really had any field position. So.
Viking press attack! What you know about the black blue? What you know about the Viking crew? Wareham and the field team, now what you gonna do? Hey!
I've got Gilly with only 17 yards on two carries. The other three times he carried, he got nothing.
I had 18 yards. 18? Okay, so whatever. That's putting me. Brito had, he had like 10 yards.
10
or
yards,
something,
yeah.
Or something like that.
You guys took your mics off, right?
No, my mic's on.
I took mine off, so.
Party.
you know, it's not filled. But...
I don't see Delgado out there, so.
You see him on the sideline?
No, that's what I'm looking at.
Wow.
Here he comes. He's coming in the golf cart.
Yeah. He's got his pads off, so he's not going to play anymore. Here's Jilly.
Oh,
he's got a hole. There he goes. Nice run there.
A pivot coming for Giving Jarro. They'll give the Wareham Vikings a first down in enemy territory.
That was close to 35 yards, wasn't it, Paul?
I'm going to count right now. 20, 35, yep, 35 yards run back.
Did your mic die?
I don't know.
First and 10?
No, it's not you.
At the 38-yard line.
Is it okay? Can you hear me?
Hand off to Gilly Jarro. Wow, he's got some big yardage.
Gilly Jarro on the run with the Vikings. First down.
Paul, how many yards was that? About 13?
About 12, 13 yards.
That's what I saw last week, a lot of those kind of runs.
Stop on the play by the canal, then we'll bring up second down.
Thank you.
Thank you. Is Gilly on the carry? Gilly Jarro. Third and nine, a long nine to go.
Third and nine for the Vikings.
Yes.
All right,
good.
Come on.
Completed pass on the play to Henry Jones. It'll be first and goal for the Vikings.
That was about 25 or 30 yards probably. I think that's the first pass they've thrown to Henry today, so.
Offside.
Yeah, look to me like procedure on Wareham.
Ball starting, the Vikings will bring up first and goal.
You're welcome, fellas.
Thank you.
Alright, the iPad is up. Nico is trying to direct. Everyone keep their cameras on as soon as you get to them. Alex should already be recording. And Joey's already recording, and as soon as Amaya sets up, she'll record. Keep recording.
Procedure again.
Now this one's on, this is offsides on, right. By Bourne, so.
This was on infraction on the canal, and they got first and goal.
This is just like the start of the game, Paul. One penalty on each team, you lose five and you get it right back.
me who doesn't like
Grand Auto. I don't like Grand Auto.
He gave me the poor AB face.
And Dr. Gilly, he's got the touchdown.
Right of the play by Jimmy Jarrow is a touchdown for the Raven Vikings. Timeout Redhead scores 6-0.
That was a nice drive by Wareham, Paul. It's the first lead they've had over Bourne in the last couple years, so.
Check the beat audio is the same. It should, but it's shut off a couple times on its own. I just want to make sure. The audio mixer again.
Like Wareham's going for two here, Paul.
Do you hear what he just said?
Veteran quarterback Elijah Carrion. Oh, and Jackson spins in for the two.
The 2-point try is good for the Vikings. For Rakeem Jackson.
Let's go!
The score, 8-0.
Like 3:30 seconds or something on the clock. So 3 seconds.
Right.
No.
So now the guy has to go down there and use a manual clock.
Taken on the 22-yard line.
Big tackle by the Vikings will give the commandment about the 31-yard line.
Henry Jones.
Henry Jones on that tackle.
Beautiful tackle. Yeah.
About the 31-yard line.
Are you still at the station?
two, 3 yards?
One of the player number 13, Logan Cook, will bring it up second down for the Canalmen.
Second and five. Gave an extra yard in that one. Ball's at the 36-yard line.
Sorry, brother.
Second down. Got the first down, I think.
Wrong play out of the third. Jamin Scott will bring up third down for the Canalmen.
No, it's going to be short.
It's like he needs about two yards, Paul.
Who's that? Indiana trying to sneak you around.
So we're not going by the scoreboard clock here.
We're not going to know how much time is left. So.
That exchange again.
I don't think he made it.
He only got about a yard.
Tackle on the play will bring up fourth down for the Canalmen.
Looks like they're going to go for it, Paul.
They got it.
That's a quarterback sneak.
First down. One.
Well, the play by number 11, Sean McDonough, will be good for a Bourne first down.
Ball on the 41-yard line. 42, actually. Again, we can't tell how much time is left here in the third quarter. Clock is inoperable at the moment.
Catch back. Number four. Got a big gain. Another first down. Two in a row.
A first down run for Jamin Scott.
Jamin Scott, yep.
Down to the 46-yard line of Wareham. First and 10.
Ryan O'Connor will bring up second down.
Bourne's been pounding Wareham up the middle most of the game, but the last couple of plays they've gone to the outside. So.
Big game. 9-yard carry for O'Connor on that one. Second and a short one to go. Oh,
Wareham's got it.
Jackson.
Beautiful. Time is currently being kept on the field by the officials.
What do we got here?
So Wareham takes over.
That's at least
on their own 39-yard line.
That's Bourne's fourth
turnover. Yep, for the Canalmen.
And Rakeem Jackson recovered the fumble.
The smallest guy on the field. So.
Here's Gilly. Jallo to the outside. He's got the first down.
Wow, he's got two guys on his back. And he's got it.
For Gilly Jallo will bring up a first down for the Vikings.
That was 12, wasn't it?
13 yards.
13.
I'm sorry.
Nice tackle there by number 14 by Boyne. Logan Cook.
Second down.
Did I hear someone ask?
No gain on the play. Second and 10. Jackson and Brito in the in the backfield. Single eye formation. There's a big hole for Jackson. Gets about 4 or 5. Oh, make it 4.
5 yards by Rakeem Jackson will bring up third down for the Vikings.
Third and 6. Hayden Lopes calling plays for the Wareham Vikings in this series. Sophomore quarterback. Ball on the 45-yard line. Jackson bounces to the outside. Gets about 2 or 3.
Short run of the play by Rakeem Jackson will bring up fourth down for the Vikings.
I think they're going to go for it, Brad.
They might as well at this point.
Yeah. Let's see what they call here.
Gilly's out of the game at this point. They got Rakeem in there instead.
Jackson. Good second effort, and I think he's got it.
He's got the first down.
A good second effort by Rakeem Jackson will be at the first down for the Vikings. Oh,
and another lineman down for Wareham.
Oh,
wow.
It's Brandon Flynn again.
Brandon Flynn, yep. Another.
He was down earlier in the game, too, so.
So coming to the sidelines gingerly is Brandon Fram, senior offensive lineman. First and 10 on the 35-yard line. Hayden Lopes calling signals. Big hole for Jackson.
4 yard run by Rakeem Jackson will bring up second down for the Vikings.
Now we got a Bourne player on the field. Number 14, Logan Cook. Sophomore. They're going down like flies, Fred.
I hate to see this, Paul.
Yeah.
You never want to see a player get injured, so you got to get bumps and bruises, so.
Ben's gonna help him hit his zoom.
Play resumed. Second down for the Wareham Vikings.
Second and five for Wareham. Jackson thrown for a loss of about a yard.
On the play by Rakeem Jackson for a 1 yard loss. Brings up third down.
Two down territory here. Third and five. Almost six. Gilly. Giallo to the outside. It's about a yard and a half
shot. Running play by Gilly Giallo. Just short at the first down. We'll bring up fourth down for the Vikings.
They're obviously going to go for it here, Paul.
Yeah, it's an obvious choice here for Coach Cass.
Another score here would be huge. So.
Time out, Bourne.
At the end of the third quarter, your score, Wareham Vikings 8.
That was the quarter, Brad.
Yeah.
Zero.
We thought it was a timeout, but we haven't got the clock's not working, so they're keeping it on the field. So.
Fourth and one on the 30... 9 yard line.
Actually, it's on the
29 yard line.
Yeah, 27 yard line.
Gilly Giallo, uh-oh.
I don't think so.
That's going to be close. I don't think he's got it.
I don't either.
First down. Wow.
Wow.
1 yard pickup.
Oh, I see my dad. That's a great sign.
Run of the play results in a first down for the Vikings.
Gilly Giallo, cut back, gets a few yards.
Another five, Paul.
Jimmy Jallo to the 22-yard line. Second down.
Gilly's been a real workhorse most of this game.
Yeah, he sure has.
That looked like offsides to me on Bourne.
Offsides on Bourne.
Yeah.
Neutral zone infraction.
Neutral zone infraction on the defense. 5-yard penalty.
Making first down.
It'll be second and one for your Vikings.
They get two shots at this one, Brad.
Yeah.
And only a yard or less for the first down.
They're down inside the 20 now, so red zone.
Pitch to Gilly Jallo. He's got the first down and more. Down to about the 6 or 7.
Gilly Jallo on the run. Results in a first down for the Vikings.
Ball's on the 14-yard line. Aiden Lopez calling the play. Landon Brito with nothing on that carry.
Running the play by Landon Brito.
Looks like that one lost maybe a yard.
Is Gilly Jallo.
Yeah, that's a
big
nice
run to the 5-yard line.
Gilly Jallo for a run of 7 yards. That'll bring up a third down for the Vikings.
They're definitely in two down territory now, Paul.
It's supposed to last 3 hours. It didn't even last that.
Oh, and I've been just shut off, so congratulations, Amaya. You're the star of the show.
Oh, you're not wide?
Well, she was right there. There was just a play.
I know. I'm kidding.
Brito, excuse me. Aiden Lopez calling the play. It's Gilly Jallo in the end zone for a touchdown. His second
Gilly
one.
Gilly Jallo leaps in the end zone for a Vikings touchdown.
It's a 7-yard run. Gilly's second touchdown of the day.
Gilly's starting to pile up the yardage, Paul.
14 to nothing.
Like Vikings.
14 nothing at this point.
Hey,
Well, we got a timeout here, Paul? Or?
Yeah, timeout.
Who called the timeout?
Vikings did.
Vikings did.
Why? I don't know.
It's on the extra point, but he gives them a chance to rest, and then they'll be back on defense. So.
And I think that we got one left, one more timeout left. Or was that their first?
I think that might
be. One called the other one.
Yeah, I think that's their first. So. So Raheem's in there on this one.
Double wideouts to the right here, Jones and Dezzy Powell.
Yep.
Oh, a little pass to
Down the barrel.
2-4.
That brings the score 16-0 for the Vikings. The scoreboard is currently malfunctioning. The time is being kept on the field by the referees. I will keep you updated with the score as we continue.
So that was a big score, Brad.
That might have.
Yeah.
After a lackluster first half, Paul, the Vikings have come out and moved the ball quite well. They seem to be wearing Bourne down at this point, so.
The ball at the 15. Cuts back. Nothing much there. Up to about the 19-yard line.
Brings the ball out to the 29-yard line. It'll be first down for the Canalmen.
You'd think Bourne's going to have to open their offense up a little bit.
You would think so.
At 16-0, I don't think they can keep running it all the time. I'm not sure they have any passing, though, so. I haven't shown the ability to really pass the ball today, so.
Short gain of about.
On the brave, our ball will bring up a second down for the Canalmen.
About 4.5 yards. Very unusual to see this full house backfield that Bourne's running on offense, Brad.
I know it. It's just impossible to pass from that formation, so.
Offsides again, Bourne.
That's it. Legal procedure. Yep. Legal procedure. The man was in motion.
Yep.
Ball start on Bourne.
I think it was the fullback.
I agree. Yeah.
To the outside.
Uh-oh.
Number 4, Jalen Scott, has got a long touchdown.
Yeah, player number four, Jamin Scott.
Oh, and another guy down, Gilly Gallo is down.
The score, 18 to 6. 16 to 6.
He's a...
One forced to go for the two here.
Pay attention.
Offsides.
On Wareham.
Offsides on the Vikings will bring up first and goal. First, sorry.
At the distance of the goal. Got it. 14 to 8.
2-point try is good for the Canal men. That brings the score to 16 to 8.
What do you think, Paul? There's about 7 or 8 minutes left, or?
Looks like it's 7:24.
Is that running now?
Yeah. If they're going by that clock, it's 7 minutes and 24 seconds.
I'd be a little careful of an onside kick here, too. Coach is concerned about it, Paul.
Yeah, he is.
He's got the kids up much closer than they were. Wants them right at the 10-yard line there. 10 yards from the kick.
Here's the 11th man coming out to the field. He only had 10.
Heck, well.
Kicks it out of bounds.
Ball goes out of bounds. The Vikings will start with the football at the 40-yard line. Estimate of time is 5 minutes remaining in the game.
Well, Wareham needs a couple of first downs here, Brad, to ice this game.
That's right. It looks like Gilly's back out there.
Yeah, he's back out there.
I guess he's okay.
Thank you. Here he is spinning for three or four, maybe five.
We're on the play by Gilly Zalo.
Another born canalman is down on the turf.
Unofficially, I've got Gilly for over 80 yards at this point, so.
Counting that run back on the kickoff?
No, I'm like not counting that one, because it wouldn't.
That one went for about 35?
Yes, yep. Now, that's unofficial. He could have more yards than that, so. All right. And I'm not, he might have had a few losses that you would normally subtract, so. From his total. But.
Yeah.
Is this a Wareham player or a
no, it's a Bourne, it's a Bourne player.
Bourne player? See. Been a lot of kids banged up in this one, I'll tell you that.
On his own accord, which is good. Oh, it was a 6-yard run by Gilly.
There's a Bourne player jumping again, Paul.
Yep, another neutral zone infraction.
Yep.
That should be enough for a first down, too.
You got to wonder if Wareham's caught.
No, it's going to go against Wareham.
Really?
Wow.
Wow, that sure looked like.
Yeah.
Ball starting, the Vikings will bring up second and 9.
To Gilly, cuts to the outside. Wow, and he's got a first down. Wow. 9-yard carry.
Gilly Hewell on the run will bring up, that's a first down for the Vikings.
That's a big first down, Brad.
Let's just keep that clock running, Paul. Yeah. Get first downs and this game's over. As long as we don't, can't have any turnovers.
Here's a hole for Gilly again. You were right, Brad. He's been a workhorse today.
Gilly, 0 for another first down.
Wow.
What was that, about 10 or 11, 12?
9-yard and a 10-yard run. Gilly Jallo.
He's close to over 100 now, Paul.
And another set of downs.
They got to be eating the clock here. I'm surprised the Bourne coach isn't trying to stop it by calling timeouts.
Oh, big hole for Jackson. Big hole.
What a run. What a great run. Wow, he ripped it out.
Joaquin Jackson with a monster run brings up a first and goal for the Wareham Vikings.
That kid, they just couldn't get him down, probably wouldn't go down. That's a great run, I'll tell you.
And they moved the ball back a couple of yards, so that second effort didn't count. Ball's on the 4-yard line.
That was about 20 yards.
First and goal. Close to it. First and goal.
Timeout Vikings.
I think that's the second now.
Oh yeah, the clock was ticking down.
Yeah. I don't want to take a 5-yard penalty down there for delay a game.
That's a big touchdown
for Joaquin the Dream Jackson.
It makes it 22 to 8. It could be the ball game.
Just speculating, there can't be much more than a couple minutes at the most left here. So.
Two and change.
That's quite a punch, that 1-2 punch, Paul. Jackson and Gilly.
And Gilly. Gilly Jalo.
When you can take Gilly out and put Raheem in.
Now they got Landon Brito and Gilly in the backfield. Pass to Desi Powell.
And he's in the end zone.
What's your point of motion is good for Desi Powell. The score for your Vikings, 24, the Brown Canalman, 8.
And it looks like the Wareham Vikings have equaled their win total from last year already, Brad, into the second week of the season.
I agree. And
with a couple minutes here left in this game, 24-8.
They're on the road, yeah, next week, I believe.
Yeah, next week we're at
Fairhaven.
Fairhaven. What's
24-8.
Wareham.
8.
There can't be much time left. A couple minutes at the most.
The clock is
on. You on last? Your camera.
Short kick.
Don't let him get outside.
The flag's all over the field here.
This is
hey, Christian.
Yeah, sorry.
Multiple flags on the play.
I'm guessing they've all got to be on Bourne.
Blocking the back?
Yeah, maybe clipping, whatever. Oh, there's
double foul.
Yeah, so it's offsetting.
Yeah. Marked at the 30-yard line. About a 10-yard return on that one, Brad.
Yeah. They're still in that full backhouse there. Backfield, Paul.
Same play they ran the touchdown on, but Landon Brito, Johnny on the spot there.
Number four, Jamin Scott, good play at Bowen at first down. There's a flag on the play.
What's that penalty?
Personal foul.
Is that on
number four? I think it's going to go against Bourne, Brad. No? Yep. Personal foul, Bourne.
Unsportsmanlike foul on the Bourne Canalman.
15 big ones.
He didn't like the way the way him tackled him, but it looked to me like a clean tackle. Yeah. So
that one hurt. That was a big first down there.
Yeah.
All the way back to the 22-yard line of Bourne. Can't be much time here, Brad. I know the scoreboard is out completely now.
Yeah. No, there's not. The one's in no hurry. I don't understand it, but it's like they didn't realize. Like they're almost giving up here.
Fumble on the play.
Fumble on the play. Still Bowen football.
I believe that's the sixth time they fumbled the ball today.
Joseph Carrara.
They got two of them back, Paul.
Yeah.
But Wayham got four of them. So.
Wow. Wow, big play by Wayne Parker there, number 60, busting in from the right.
That's a sack for the Vikings. That brings up third down for the Canalmen.
He had help from Dominic Lavelle, too, for Paul. They were both right in there.
And that's it. That'll do it.
That's it.
Final score here from Spillane Field.
That's the end of the game, the final score. Your Wareham Vikings, 24, the Bourne Canalmen, 8.
24-8, the final score here. Wareham with their second win of this young season. Next week it's on to Fairhaven.
Yeah.
And we'll be back here on October 4th against Seekonk, I think it is.
Yeah, Seekonk.
Yeah. So for Brad Cornish and myself, Paul Gagel, good night. And we'll see you next time on WCTV Sports.
When you do, it's not that hard, really gonna wanna give